welcome back here to, as you can tell over my shoulder, the world of Iris. And I tell you what, this is the third time I've tried recording this week, and it's just been one of those weeks, I'm afraid. So, yeah, the first time, the build I was making, it didn't work, and then I had internet connection problems, and in the end I decided just to give up. So woe is me. The second time was alright. I did some recording and all looked good. Then I went to look at the footage and it looked like this. Yeah, it's great, isn't it? So I didn't think you guys would want to see 30 minutes of that, so I gave up on that one as well. And it's just a shame, because we got a lot done. It was really good, I thought. So this is attempt number 3. Hopefully this one will work. Fingers crossed. Only problem I can see is, you know, I don't actually noticeably have fingers, so that might actually cause some problems. We'll see. But let's go through it again anyway. Last couple of times, and I'm getting quite rehearsed at this now, we started off by having a look at a couple of new players' rooms. And one of them was Rawley Sims here, number 5, who I think has done an absolutely epic job here on a really nice modern looking apartment. So we've got the chairs to sit on here, some books in the corner. I do like that. The smallest room really is small. Ooh, never noticed that before. Nice little bit of hidden storage. And there's a kitchen here, and she has put in a usable fridge, which is great. Filled it with food, looking marvellous. Cake on the table there. And a nice little view over the balcony here. So I think, you know, this is an excellent, excellent, excellent build. And I'm really looking forward to what Rawley can do. I've seen her Minecraft series, and incidentally, she's just started a new Sims 4 series today as I'm recording this, so go watch it. It's good. And yeah, so that's that one. I'm really happy to see that one. And here, if we just skip around Zombie Too Many Fandoms here, there's, and have a sneak peek into her room. And I like this one as well. It's different. This one's functional as opposed to decorative. So we've got some storage in here, furnaces and a crafting bench. The carpet's all snow blocks, which I think is great. And is that lift? Yeah, that is elevated. That is elevated. It's elevated using stairs, isn't it? Yeah, it is. I quite like that. That's obviously on snow blocks, and that's looking great rather than using carpet. Rather familiar choice in leather armour there. And yeah, a little bit of work done on the outside here, which is looking great. Nice view, or at least it will be a nice view fairly soon. Over there is going to be a new building soon. And yeah, so that one is really good as well. I'm going to finish my sentence. That's what I'm going to go do. I'm going to really, really look forward to seeing what these guys are building on the server. And thinking of that, one of them has built something on the server. And this is dedicated to Miss Fujimoto on the live stream, who once, when seeing a potato on the floor of a bus, pointed at it and shouted, "Potato meow!" And so, Too Many Fandoms has built us here a statue of Potato Meow. So I think this is fun. On the outside, has a catty look to it. Yes, it's a bit of a sphinx, though admittedly there's only one of them, so it's probably just a sphinx. Interesting design here. used up lots of our sandstone, which is good because we were getting so much of it. And okay, so that's the meow bit. So where's the potato bit? Inspired by Miss Fujimoto. Alright, so there's the potato. At least one of them. And the rest of them, and I like this bit, are all growing up here. Which is amusing. Alright, so we got our own little potato farm. And we go up here to... we've got another room being prepared here, so... Looks like... Too Many Fandoms is starting a Miss Fujimoto-inspired... potato shop. And why not? So there we go. Potato Meow. Right. What else can we do here? I'm going to do a little bit of a build. This is only going to be a short episode today, I'm afraid, because I've had so many difficulties recently. I'm really, really cramped on time this week. And rather than not do anything this week, I wanted to get a few episodes out. So I will be trying to get a Meet the Grabbers episode out the weekend. And there's a couple other bits and pieces I'm going to try to rush out. But it's not going to be as big an episode as I normally would do. So my apologies there, and I hope you guys will forgive me this once. Now, what was I going to do? What I'm going to do is I'm going to finish off this project. And I'm going to finish it off with you guys. So, here we are. This is the walls. Last time we were working on the walls, we were over there. And since then, I've done all this up here. And the walls are effectively finished now. So we can just have a quick run around the top here. And that's precisely what we're going to do. Let's have a quick run around. As you can see, now you can use them to easily get around the entire base. Which I think is great. So running around behind Melody Flower's shop here. And we'll come up to the wall shop here. That's my tower over there, you can see. And this is all joining up together. And eventually, once the gatehouses are done, which is going to be the next step, this will be a complete circuit of the town. And we should be able to get this place as mob-free as possible. I mean, this place looks like a bomb's hit it at the moment, which is a bit unfortunate. But hopefully we'll get this bit tidied up. This is still a bit of a mess. But the walls themselves are in, and they're up, and they're stopping mobs from getting in. They seem to be doing the job quite well. So I'm quite happy with that. And when I say the walls are done, I'm not entirely telling the truth, because there is one stretch of walls that is still needs to be built. Well, it's about half built at the moment, and we're going to finish the job off. And I'm thinking let's do that this episode, okay? So let's go here across the wood bridge. And over here... okay, here we go. Right. There's the pub, which is turned into our meeting room, I think. It's a great place to do it. So here we are. This is the last stretch of walls. The very, very last bit that needs to be done. As you can see, the main wall is up, but we're going to need a walkway. We're going to need some stairs, a bit of lighting. And the very top of it needs to be done. So I'm going to do that with you guys right now, if you don't mind. And the first thing I need to do is concentrate on the uprights. And the uprights tend to be a mixture of a block and a set of stairs like that. Or three blocks, you know, to indicate a bit more strength there in the corner. So we'll do that there. Do that there. Eat a bit of steak. Nom, 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 nom. Okay, and there we go, that's the uprights done. And we need to get one place here to get actually up onto the walls. And the only real place to do it is here really, isn't it? So let's do it here. So to do that, we're going to put a few stairs. We've got a few ladders up like that. And we need to put a trapdoor, and I happen to have one left up there to get through. So we'll put... that like that, and that when we built the rest, that will be the way up. So let's build the rest quickly. And the rest is, as you might have guessed, oak slabs. And we're just going to build all that out quickly like this, and that will give us a floor to run along up the top there. So basically we're just doing a two wide walkway all the way around the walls, I mean, you saw me run around a lot of it earlier on. This bit here, this goes out too, like that, and that way we've got a nice big square. The trees are overhanging a little bit, but I don't think that actually matters that much at this point. So, one went wrong. Let's put that one up again. Like that, and like that, and there we go, that's that bit done. We're almost done with the bottom bit here, but what I want to do here is make sure I've got some lighting in, so I just want to press F3 just to make sure that this is lit up well enough around. There we go, there's a 7 there, so that's a slight problem. So I'm thinking that I'm going to change this one, and we'll make this a... Where's my... There we go. Okay, so we'll put some square blocks in like that, and then we'll... Where are they? There we go. We'll put a bit of fencing there and put a torch on the top. Let's have a look at the light going around here. You see, that's now above 7, so nothing will actually spawn here. But we'll repeat it over the other side here. And that'll give us a good bit of light. There's still light over the other side here. That's going to improve things as well. And just finish that off on all of these here. So we put a light there, and a light there. There we go. Okay, and just looking at the lighting level here. Second row from the bottom of the information there. If the light number drops below 7, then their mobs can spawn in the area at night. That's all good. Okay. So, that's the bottom of the wall done. So now all we need to do is just dress the side of the walls and put some extra lighting on. So it's all going to look like this bit here, you can see. And that is going to require us to... Don't need those anymore, but we do need fence posts. I'm not sure if we've got enough of those, but we'll find out. So we start off like that, and then we put stairs in between, like this, and then back like that, and stairs in between, and like that. And guess what? Yep, stairs in between. One left over, that's not bad. And there we go, like that. That's the wooden part, and now all we need to do is finish off the fencing parts and put some lights on it, which we're going to do right now. So let's just stick some fencing across the top here. What is this going to do? Well, there's two things for this. The first one, and in a way perhaps the most important, is it does make the walls look good, I think. And the other one is it's going to make it a lot harder for spiders to climb the walls, because spiders can climb up and they can climb down, but they can't climb out. We are one short. Let's go and make ourselves, find ourselves some more of those. That'll do us. And let's pop in here, up the walls, point. And let's just put in that last one there. That's it. Okay. And the final job is to get some torches up. And the torches are going to go on these ends pieces here. Like that. But we also want to put some in the middle here. Now, this one is even, so we put 2 in the middle to balance it out. And this one is odd. This one is even. And this one's very long. This is a bit of an odd one. So what I think I'm going to do here is I'm just going to put them like that, space them out a little bit. And I think that looks quite nice. That seems to be lacking a torch, as does that one. And I think we are done. It's taken me, about 4 or 5 months, possibly even longer to get this all done. But now... Not counting the gatehouses, of course. Now we should be able to do a complete wall around the outer walls without worrying about anything, and we can drop into the towers. The towers now, if anybody wants to build on a tower, they are welcome to build on the tower. That's my invitation to the nice people at the service. If anyone wants to build a gatehouse, please, please, please build a gatehouse. I think that would look absolutely marvelous if everybody had a different style gatehouse. But in the meantime, we've now got this nice sheltered place where we can build in peace, assuming of course we got the lighting right, and we're getting close to getting the lighting right. And from time to time perhaps we can stand here on the towers, on the walls, look out upon our world and sneer at the commoners and perhaps shoot the odd bits and piece and miss, and jobs are good. And I think I'm really happy with the way this has turned out. I don't know if I've shown this off, so I'm going to show this off anyway. This is Melody Flowers Bridge, and we need to name it. Do I have any signs? No, let me just put down a crafting bench. Let me just get in here so it's a bit safer. Let me put down a crafting bench. Oh, I actually have a crafting bench, that's good. Pop that down, let's make a few signs here quickly. Oh. Start off with some sticks. Always useful things to have when making signs. Put a stick at the bottom there. Gives us three signs. Let's grab that bench back. There we go. And let's call this one something new. We'll call this one, and the clever naming convention we've had already, the Birch Bridge. There we go, the Birch Bridge. Yeah, I think I spelled that right. I think we're going to be getting rid of this bit of earth here, but yeah, it comes across quite nicely. I quite like this. This is a mixture of birch planks and birch logs. And if you look down there, the water is actually simulated. I think possibly because this is, yeah, if you look at this is actually too shallow. So what Melody's done here is she's put, it looks like lapis blocks. There's a small fortune in that. Oh, I see. She ran out of lapis blocks at that point and switched to blue wool, which has probably a much cheaper and better alternative, I would say. So it just looks like there's water underneath the glass, and with a good bit of lighting, that I think that looks really, really bright and impressive. And yeah, good build there, Melody. Very good build. So there you have it. That is the walls, and that is actually something marked off my list of things to do. So what I'm going to do is I've got a couple of very quick things to do, and then I'm going to go to the tower, and I will get rid of that. Don't need that anymore. And let's say hello. Hello. Recording right now. There we go. And yeah, so I'll cut back in just a second. And what we'll do is we will update my wall of things to do, which actually one of them should be find it a better name. To see you in a sec. Well, hello, and here we are back at my little tower. My little tower, it's the biggest tower in the game, but well, apart from that one, if you're going to be pedantic. And yes, so here we are. This is my wall of things to do. So this is stuff that I would like to get done soon, and this is my foremost highest priority items. Oh, and by the way, yeah, I've been doing a little bit of redecorating in here. As you can see, some of the chests are in. I think I'm going to leave the space across front of the window here like that, because I quite like it. Just a nice little bit of space there. And the chests, I'm probably going to fill up this gap back here with chests, and down here as well. And there's a room here which I'm going to completely fill with chests as well. And finally, here's the roof. I don't know what I'm going to do with the roof, but it's probably going to involve chests the way things are going. But still, let's go back and have a look at my wall of things to do. So now, finish the walls. I can take that down, but you haven't done the gatehouses. Yes, but it's there. That's the gatehouses. So I think what I want to do here is I want to take one of these eight and put it up there. And I'm thinking that the one I want to do, it's not going to be the most exciting one, but I'm going to put this one, take that one down, and I'll put it up here. So that is roads in Iris. Okay, and let me just show you what that means quickly. We just pop out of here. We've got the classic example. The road just kind of stops here a little bit. And all the way around here is exactly the same. It's just a hole where the road should be, which is not quite good enough. So one of the jobs I want to do soon as get this down. This is mostly cobblestone, as you can see, but the design requires just a bit of stuff to break it up. So you've got some bricks, you've got some smooth stone here. Just making it a little bit easier on the eyes. And so that needs to go, we need the ring road to get around there finished. And there's another ring road over that way which needs to be finished. It's the cobblestone's down, but it doesn't have the bits breaking it up. And I also want to go through everything and do some pumpkin lanterns on the sides of the roads. That way we are pretty much guaranteeing light quality without having these torches all over the place as much as possible. I know it doesn't quite look right, and I might experiment with the leaf types, but it still looks better, I think. If you look at this side against that side, you know, I think this side looks nicer because it doesn't have the torches all over the place. And you just don't find that in cities. So there we go. And that means I've got to think of something to put here. And there's lots and lots and lots of things to do. But I think the one I'm going to put up here is, I want some beacons in Iris. And that is probably one we're going to do soon, because it's a nice easy one to do. You just kill lots of withers and then you make a large pile of iron and put the wither stars on top of it. And it's worth pointing out that we've had a place waiting for three beacons for a very, very long time, and still in terms of this server, which is in here in the library. And the library was designed with the very idea of us building beacons down here that would go through those holes in the ceiling. So we'll probably end up doing that fairly soon. Wither fights ho. Which is going to be nice, because one of the things I want to put here, actually, is I want to do another one of these nice little displays here. So, you know, sort of showing the people that fought the dragon. Was that really November? Oh, it's so very long ago. So there's me, I'm a Mage, Hell Kitty, and Charbel. And these three don't come on the server anymore, unfortunately. But there we go, we'll build one over here to the people, dedicated to the people who fight the Wither, which is why I put this up, actually. And, well, I think that's enough. I've actually waffled for much longer than I thought I was going to. Hopefully this one will work, because quite frankly, I'm sick of doing this. And we'll see you all next time, where I shall do something a bit more structured. So until then, I've been Simon Parsons. That has been a statue of a turret. Thank you and good night.